Hey, good morning and welcome to Living Hope. Thank you for joining us. Here's some information that we want you to know.
We worship the God who was. We worship the God who is. We worship the God who evermore will be. He opened the prison door. He parted the raging sea. My God, He holds the victory.
Hey, good morning and welcome to Living Hope. Thank you for joining us. Here's some information that we want you to know. Hey, good morning and welcome to Living Hope. Thank you for joining us. Here's some information that we want you to know.
podcast. I hope you are glad to see us this morning. We're glad to be here. Oh, thanks, y'all. Thank you. Well, you know, we love our Living Hope family, that's for sure. I know we're supposed to, I guess, get started on time. I guess I was waiting for more people to show up, but I just got a new promotion at work. There's just a few of us there, so I'm the office administrator. So normally I'm like about 5 minutes late, so guess what? I'm not late anymore. I'm earlier on time because, you know, anyway, so I thought today I needed to be on time too to start. So sorry we're starting a little bit late, but welcome you guys and welcome everybody online that's watching today. And, you know, we just want to worship the Lord in spirit and truth today. And I know that's your heart and that's my heart, is to worship the Lord. A worship leader friend of mine, Maddie, she says, this is something she said one day that just really stuck with me. You know how we'll tell people to get out of your comfort zone and worship God? Worship is our comfort zone. When she said that, I was like, yes, that is your comfort zone. That is my comfort zone. And the enemy wants to lie to us and tell us we're not good enough. We got to do something to get close to God. But God's already done that for us in Jesus. And we can come boldly to his throne this morning. Amen. And if we have unconfessed sin, all we have to do is confess it, because he is faithful and just to forgive us, you know, when we call upon him. Amen. You know, so I just want you and me, we're going to worship today and fill this place with our praises. And online, when you're at home, just get crazy in your living room. And I know that online stuff is a little hard, you know, especially if your husband's there and you kind of want to dance around or whatever, but and he may not be into that or something, but let's just stand today and you just worship how you're feeling, how you and Jesus, how you're comfortable today, because he is our comfort zone, being in the presence of the Lord. Lord, we love you. We worship you today. We bow down and say you are worthy, worthy, worthy.
There's nothing better than you, Lord. There's nothing.
are love, yes you are. You bring light to the darkness. You give hope, you restore every heart that is broken.
Shout your praise, our hearts will cry, these bones.
us into you, into your presence at your feet. Here in your presence is where we long to be. sometimes we find ourselves, you know, singing our songs, and maybe that's not the desire of our heart. Maybe we want other things than you. Lord, if you could change the heart of a king, Lord, you could change my heart. Lord, you can change our hearts. Lord, open our eyes to see the beauty and the splendor of who you are. And just how much you love us. Lord, that our desires would line up with you and your desires, God. How great is your love for us, Lord. No other love compares to yours. Lord. Draw us into you today. Draw us into the place that we never. Can separate us from his love. He just wants you to know that today. Nothing can separate us from his love. And he's running after us. He's pursuing us with his loving kindness.
just hate to interrupt anything, so we won't. We'll stay here in the presence of God. You know, in that song where he is enough. He is enough. And I forget that a lot. I think about the things I think I need, but he is enough. And you know, where it says he doesn't owe me anything. He doesn't. He doesn't owe me a thing. He's already given me everything I need. So thank you, Jesus. With that being said, I know there are a lot of people that have needs today. There's a lot of people that are hurting, that are sick, that are facing a lot of things in their life. And first of all, I want to say Jesus is enough to meet those needs.
Yes, amen.
But we need to remember them and lift them up in prayer. There's a couple of people that have asked or need prayer. One of them, well, there's more than a couple of people that need it, but there's a friend of Teresa, and I'll probably get this name wrong, but it's Hempton that needs prayer. Lou's daughter, Dawn, she needs prayer. She needs God to work in her life. We know of people that have been going here for a while that have need prayer. They need a miracle. So we just want to lift these needs up to you. Jerry mentioned somebody else, and it, one thing, if y'all noticed, Patty and Jerry are not here today, and it's not because they've gone on vacation or something. Some of their family members have been exposed to the virus, and they were around them. They're not sick, but for everybody's safety, they are staying away. I know they're with us in spirit, and we thank them for that, and we want to lift up their family. Hayden Worthington has RSV and needs prayer. Jason Orange has a kidney stone, and he needs prayer. So if y'all would just, let's lift these people up. Let's just lift them up to the Lord. And Father, as we come to you in the name of your Son, Jesus, we know that you are enough. You are enough for all the needs. It's hard for us to imagine, but you're aware of what everyone is going through all at the same time, and you're able to meet their needs all at the same time. It's not like you're limited to just so many miracles and then you're done. There is no limit to you. So we lift these people up to you, Father. We pray that your spirit would be upon them even now, healing their bodies. We pray for those that are dealing with cancer, God, that you would just destroy these cancer cells in the name of Jesus. Just destroy them and renew their bodies, Lord. Father, with this virus that's going around, we just need you. We need you to protect us, but we need you to destroy this virus. And we ask you to, Father. Nothing is too great for you to do. And we just look to you, Father. And Father, we thank you that you are always ready to listen when we call upon you.
Yes.
And God, we ask that you would help us to be willing to listen when you desire to speak to us. Help us to have eyes that see and ears that hear, not of the things in the world, but the things that are in the Spirit. For it's in Christ's name we pray. Amen. So I'm going to share something with y'all. I hadn't been into a doctor in quite some time. And I went a couple months ago. And, you know, it was good to go. It was good to go. There's a lot of good reasons to go see a doctor on a regular basis that I was overlooking, you know. And it's not because I was sick. It was to see where I was at, see if I did have anything that I didn't know about. And so it was good. And we all need to go see a doctor sometime. You know, it's hard to admit that. But one of the hardest things to me is when I went was to be honest with the doctor. Because to start with, I'd never been to her before, and that's scary. And it's hard to be honest and admit that you're human, admit that you might have some kind of weakness, admit that you're just not as young as you think you are. Because a lot of times I'm thinking I'm young, and then my body says, no, you're not. You know, and I got to thinking about it, that's the same way it needs to be with God. We just need to be honest with Him. You know, God already knows everything about us, unlike the doctor who didn't even know me from, forgive me, Adam. But if I wasn't honest with them, then they couldn't help me. And the same thing with God. If we're not honest with Him, even though He already knows, we wouldn't get the help that we need. And you might ask, why am I talking about doctors and God? Well, I read the scripture. It's in Mark 2, 15 through 17. And I'm sure y'all have heard of it. But it says, while Jesus was having dinner at Levi's house, many tax collectors and sinners were eating with him and his disciples. For there were many who followed him. When the teachers of the law, who are the Pharisees, saw him eating with sinners and tax collectors, they asked his disciples, why does he eat with tax collectors and sinners? Now, that's a good question. Why isn't he having dinner with the Pharisees, with us? Why is he eating with them? And Jesus heard this, and Jesus answered him. He said, it is not the healthy that need a doctor, but the sick. And he says, I have come to call, not call the righteous, and sometimes that's self-righteous, but I've come for the sinners. And that's the same thing, you know, he came for us. You know, Jesus is called the great physician, according to Mark 2:17. He came to cure the sick and the poor in spirit, and to heal our souls and restore our relationship with God. You know, I was thinking about, I did go see a cardiologist one time, and I thought I was having a heart attack. I really did. My wife can tell you, I was scared to death. Thankfully, I was just having a panic attack. I went to see a doctor, and the doctor said the only thing I needed to do is learn to say no. She didn't say what I needed to learn to say no to, but I just learned to say no. And, you know, thinking about that, I think about my spiritual heart. And I know that God knows my heart, and I know my heart. And it's hard for me to understand why He still loves me, because I know my heart. You know, it says in Jeremiah 17:9, the heart is deceitful above all things and beyond cure. Who can stand it? I can't stand it sometimes. But God has an answer for that. God has an answer for that. And in Ezekiel 36:26, he says, I will give you a new heart and put a new spirit in you. I will remove from you your heart of stone and give you a heart of flesh. Now, just like it says, the heart of man is deceitful and beyond cure. God didn't say, I'll fix your heart. He said, I'll give you a new heart. And I got to thinking about that. And I've got somebody who's very close to me that got a new heart. He had a heart attack and went through quite a bit. I remember going up to ICU and praying with him and wondering what is going to happen from here. I'm thankful to say he's still around and still going strong. But I got to thinking about two things. One thing is, for him to get a new heart, someone had to die. And I got to thinking about our spiritual heart. And for us to get a new spiritual heart, someone had to die. And that was Christ. He died for us so that we could get a new heart. And I think about some of the things that when I went to the cardiologist that they did, and one of the things they did was they give you a stress test. And I don't know how many of y'all have been there, and I'm thinking to myself, I'm under enough stress now. I don't need a test, but they give it to you. So then I was thinking about my spiritual heart, and God gives us stress tests too. In Luke 6:45, it says, a good man brings good things out of the good stored up in his heart, and an evil man brings evil things out of the evil stored up in his heart. For the mouth speaks what the heart is full of. When we're under stress, sometimes what is in our heart comes out. And I think about what comes out of my mouth, not so much when somebody's around, or how I react when I'm under stress. And I realize that I still have a heart condition. And just like my friend, he still has to go to a cardiologist. He still has to have checkups. He's on medication. He'll be on it the rest of his life. And he has to be monitored. You know, and when I was 21 years old, I gave my life to the Lord, and I believe he gave me a new heart. But I've allowed things in my life to come in, and just like with my friend, there's things he did in his life that possibly led up to his heart disease. You know, he didn't smoke, but I'm just saying there's things that we do that cause the disease. And the same thing in my life. There was things that caused my spiritual heart to be diseased. And if I'm not careful, I can get back to that. So I need to keep going to God, the cardiologist, for my spiritual heart. Because I can tell when I'm in the stress, and I see that just like the doctor, the cardiologist, could see when you're on that stress test, what's going on with your heart. I can see when I'm in stress, what comes out of my heart to know that God still needs to do some work. You know, I have a friend of mine. I won't say who he is, somebody else. But I don't know if y'all noticed yet, but I'm not real tall. And he calls me short stuff. And I just tell him I'd rather be short than ugly. But I remind him in the scripture in 1 Samuel, I always say, you know, the tall guy was rejected. And I'm sure you are aware of in the Bible when it talks about in 1 Samuel 16, when Samuel was going to look for the new king of Israel to anoint him. And when he went there to Jesse's house, his first oldest son comes up, and he's tall and handsome, and Samuel just knew that had to be him. You know, strong, you know. And God said, no, He said, I don't look on the outside, I look on the inside. He's after what's in our hearts. He doesn't care if you're short, tall, thin, bald-headed, long hair, beard. He doesn't care anything, color of our skin. He doesn't care anything at all about that. He only cares about what's on the inside. And you know, this kind of just proves out what God is more concerned about when it comes to our heart. In Luke 18:10 through 14, it talks about two men that went up to the temple to pray. One was a Pharisee and the other one a tax collector. So now we're back to the Pharisees and the tax collectors again. You know, it seems like they get mentioned a lot in Scripture. And usually when God's talking or Jesus was talking to the Pharisee, he wasn't going, attaboy, y'all are doing good. You know, he always spoke to them and usually rebuked them. But when he spoke to the tax collectors, the sin, the woman caught in adultery and everything, he spoke to them with love, not to condone what they were doing, but to help them get out of what they were doing. So it says the Pharisee stood by himself and prayed, God, I thank you that I'm not like other people, robbers, evildoers, adulterers, or even like this tax collector. I fast twice a week, and I give a tenth of all I get. You know, there we go with our self-righteousness, telling God how good we are. And then God's probably going, not again. But it says, but the tax collector stood at a distance. He didn't come up front. He didn't make himself just stand out in a crowd or whatever. He stood at a distance. And he would not even look up to heaven, but beat his breast and said, God, have mercy on me, a sinner. And it says in the Scriptures that that day says, I tell you that this man, rather than the other, went home justified before God. For all those who exalt themselves will be humbled, and those who humble themselves will be exalted. You know, God is more concern about our spirit than he is our flesh. And we know that. The flesh is going to disappear. Our fleshly heart will one day stop beating, but our spiritual heart will not. And when we were in here one day and Patty was mentioning a song that she started to quote, and I remember this song well. And it was a song written by Chris Tomlin. It's called Give Us Clean Hands. And it's from a scripture that makes you think of the scripture in Psalms where it says 24:3-4. Who may ascend to the mountain of the Lord, and who may stand in his holy place? The one who has clean hands and a pure heart, who does not trust in idols or swear by false gods. So, if you all don't mind, I'm going to ask the worship team to come back up. And I want us to sing that prayer. I want us to sing it to God. Because I want to have clean hands and a pure heart. And I know that I can't do that on my own. I can't cleanse my own heart. I can't clean my own hands. But I know that God is able to do that. I know that God is able to once again work in my heart to reveal the things that are not clean, whether it's going through some type of stress test to see where I'm at, or just speak to me in a quiet time. Because one day we will all stand before God. And all the things that we think that are important that we could brag about that we've done in this life will mean nothing. The only thing that's going to mean anything is our relationship with Christ. You know, when I was talking about going to the doctors, one of the things that I read, it says you have to build a relationship with your doctor. And I thought, you know, that's true. But we need to build a relationship with Christ, with God, with Jesus, with the Holy Spirit. We have to have that relationship. Or, for one thing, we can't feel like we can be honest with you. You know, if you've got somebody that you have a good relationship with, you can share things that you wouldn't want anybody else to know. With that being said, I've reached out to some of the men here in this church because I want to build a relationship with them. I need that. But above all, I need a relationship with Christ. So if y'all wouldn't mind to join me in this song, but as a prayer. And I don't know if you've ever heard it before, but it's pretty simple. It talks about we bow our heart and we bend our knee. Holy Spirit, come make us humble. We turn our eyes from evil things. Oh Lord, we cast down our idols. And then we ask Him, give us clean hands. Give us a pure heart. Let us not lift our souls to another. So if y'all would sing with me.
We bow our hearts, we bend our knees. Oh Spirit, come make us humble. We turn our eyes from evil things. Clean hands, give us pure hearts.
Lord, renew a right spirit in us, Jesus.
Hearts of those who lead us, that are in Congress, for our president, our vice president, for our governors, God, those who make decisions, may they have a heart that comes from you. God, just do a work in us. Seems like we've turned so far from you, Father. Help us to come home. In their hearts and in their lives. May their eyes be opened, Lord. May those blinders that have been put on them by the evil one, may they be removed, that they may see. That they may see you, Father. And Father, we do ask that you would create in us a clean heart, O God. And renew a steadfast spirit, even as David prayed. And God, we thank you that you're the one that can do that work. You can take out this heart of stone and put a heart of flesh, a spiritual heart of life. And we thank you for that, Father. We look forward to what you're doing in our lives, in our hearts, in our families, in our city, in our state, in our country. We look forward to see what you're doing, Father.
Nothing else will do.
get in here today. I'm trying to figure that out. Oh, Jesus.
It's peaceful.
It's a peace of the Lord. Do y'all feel peaceful in this place today?
I do. And I'm thankful for it. You know, I wanted to say something about, speaking of hearts, I'm so thankful for the heart of our pastors here. You know, I tell people a lot of times, if I can't be more like Jesus, if I can be more like Jerry, I'd be going in the right direction. I'm thankful for his heart and Patty's heart that they have for people. They truly have a heart that loves people. And as Jerry says many times from up here, he's only concerned about people making it to heaven. He doesn't care how much money you have that you could give to the church. He never even thinks about that. He doesn't care about your abilities to sing and praise and everything, even though we need that. He's concerned about, are you going to make it to heaven? He's concerned about this neighborhood, the people that are around here. Not to say that there's not a lot of people here that are going to heaven, but he wants to make sure that everybody he comes in contact with, they know about Jesus. And I'm thankful for that. And the only thing that I would ask you is, through the next week, remember to pray for them and their families. But I also ask you to think about this as you go through that stress test this week. Don't beat yourself up over it if you find that you have some heart conditions that you need work with. Ask God to just be honest with you. Ask God, say, God, I see this in my heart. I see this area. Will you help me? It's the same thing when you go to a cardiologist and they see that you have a problem. If you just ignore it, you could die. The same thing with our spiritual heart. If we just ignore the issues that we have, and I'm speaking to myself more than I am to you all, that if we don't address the issues, we could die spiritually. So just think about that this week. And I know it's early, but I'm going to dismiss us in prayer. I thank y'all for coming. I thank those for that were watching online. We pray that everybody will make it back here safely, that Patty and Jerry and their family will recover. Not that Patty and Jerry are sick. They're just want to be safe because they do love y'all. And it would just devastate them if they caused any of y'all to be sick. So if you don't mind, we'll dismiss in prayer. Father, we thank you for this day. And God, I thank you that you do give us a new heart. God, we can see you working in people's lives. We hear the testimony of what you've done in their lives. And we have that same testimony of what you've done in our lives. Help us be willing to share the love of Christ with others when we come in contact with them. Help us to be a good representative of yours. And God, when we're going through those stress tests, help our eyes to be open, our spiritual eyes, and to realize the areas that we need help, and to reach out to you knowing that you are the one that can heal our hearts. For it's in Christ's name we pray.
Amen.
And there's one more thing I want to share with y'all. There's a scripture that says, delight yourself in the Lord and he will give you the desires of your heart. And I mentioned that to Teresa the other day, and she said, yeah, when I was working at Morrison's, she shared that scripture with somebody that worked there, and they said, well, good, I'm going to give my life to the Lord because I want a new car. And it's like, no, that's not what he's talking about. And you can look at it two ways. Delight yourself in the Lord and he'll give you the desires of your heart, the things that you desire that are good. But I look at it as, delight yourself in the Lord and he will put those desires in your heart, the ones that are pleasing to him and are beneficial to us.
Yep.
So just remember that. And y'all have a good week.
Thanks for being a part of the service this morning. We hope you have a great week. If you would like to rewatch Pastor's message from this morning or a previous message, check out our YouTube at Living Hope Owensboro. And if you would like to know more about what's going on here at Living Hope, find us right here on Facebook and Instagram.
We worship the God who is. We worship the God who evermore will be. He opened the prison doors. He parted the raging sea. My God.